naming cycloalkanes. We've looked at compounds like this, the alkanes, CH3, CH2, CH3, would be propane. What if we took a hydrogen off the end of propane and a hydrogen off this end and bonded those two positions together to get something like this? In other words, to form a ring or a cyclic structure. Remember, the magic number for carbon is 4, 4 bonds, so this still obeys that rule. The carbon here at the top has 2 carbon-carbon bonds, and there'd be 2 hydrogens at that position. Organic chemists are always seeking ways to abbreviate structures, it seems, and so they've abbreviated the structure of cyclopropane just with a triangle. And when you abbreviate the other cyclobutane, cyclopentane, and cyclohexane, and the ring sizes keep going on from there, you have to keep in mind that the intersection of 2 lines is a carbon, and that every carbon still has 4 bonds attached to it. So even though you don't see them, that right here at this point there are 2 hydrogens attached, at all of those points there are 2 hydrogens attached. These then would become the base words for naming cycloalkanes. Let's look at a typical structure. Here I've taken one of the hydrogens off a position on the cyclopentane ring and attached an ethyl group. Well, if we were to name this compound, cyclopentane would be the base word, that ring of 5 carbons, and then at position 1, we've got an ethyl group attached, so 1 ethyl cyclopentane. In the alkanes, when we had an open chain structure, there were always 2 ways that we could number, from the left or from the right. In a ring, we could start anywhere. And of course, we'd want to start so that we gave the lowest number to the position of an attached group. That means that if I have just 1 group attached to a ring, it's always going to be at position 1. And sometimes, because of that, they abbreviate one more step and just call this ethyl cyclopentane, knowing full well that the ethyl group is at position 1. Here's another structure. Tried to draw a 6-membered ring, so the base word would be cyclohexane. You always have to remember to put that cyclo in there. Sometimes we forget that. Then I've got a chain of 3 carbons attached in a group. And remember, a group of 3 is called propyl, and it can either be propyl or isopropyl. And in this one is isopropyl, because it's attached to the ring through that center position. So it would be 1 isopropyl cyclohexane, or just isopropyl cyclohexane. Making things just a little more complex now, I've attached 2 groups to a ring. Well, it's going to be a dimethyl cyclopentane. Base word has 5 carbons in it, base structure, so cyclopentane. And I've got 2 methyl groups, so that's where the dimethyl comes from. And again, now, with a ring, we could start numbering anywhere, but we want to give the lowest numbers to the positions of the groups. And it doesn't matter whether I begin here or up here, but it does matter which way we go around the ring. So if I were to start here and call this position 1, go 1, 2, 3, 4, I've got groups, methyl groups, at positions 1 and 4. But if I go counterclockwise, 1, 2, 3, I've got groups at 1 and 3. And according to the IUPAC system, the lowest numbers wins. This is 1,3 dimethyl cyclopentane. Let's look at a structure now where we've got 2 groups attached and they aren't the same. Here I've got a cyclobutane ring. So that would be our base word, cyclobutane. We've got a methyl group, and we've got a propyl group. It's not an isopropyl. For isopropyl, it would be attached through the center carbon, but it's just propyl. And this time, when the 2 groups are different, there's 2 possible numbering systems. I could locate the position where the methyl is as number 1, this is number 2, or we could do just the opposite. This could be number 1, and this position up here could be number two. And a special IUPAC rule comes into play when the two sets of numbers are identical. If the two sets of numbers are different, you use the lowest set, it wins. But if the two sets of numbers, 1 and 2 and 1 and 2, in this case, are identical, then we let the group that comes first alphabetically have the lowest number. So in this case, methyl beats out propyl. M comes before P alphabetically. So this is position 1 and this is position 2. The name then is 1-methyl, 2-propyl, cyclobutane. Maybe one last thing we can do with this structure. Remember, for later chapters especially, when you see the intersection of two lines, that's a carbon, and there's still going to be two more hydrogens at that position. Or in this case, where I see a group is attached, there's a carbon bond. There's only one hydrogen attached at that position.